Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. So good to have you guys back here again. Thank you once again for your continuous massive and huge support to this channel. God bless you guys. We really appreciate you, and we pray that even as you support this channel, God Almighty will support you in whatsoever you lay your hands to do, in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you guys. We do not take your support for granted. Yes, my people, as always, we're back again with latest and most authentic happenings in the country. Asewaju Bola Tinubu is lamenting, he is screaming. You know, he's eyeing 2023. He has the mind that he's going to rule the country once again. The two-time governor of Lagos State, you know, he served as governor of Lagos State for two terms. And up till now, even before the Lekki Tollgate incident and all of that, Lagosians, even Nigerians as a whole, have got reservations for the Jagaban of Lagos, Asewaju Bola Tinubu. Right now, guys, he's lamenting seriously that Lekki Tollgate killings have complicated matters for him. He knows very well that no one will vote for him. That is the end of his political career. Who will vote for Tinubu? Tinubu, all fingers are pointing to him. You know that after the killings, immediately he ran off to France. That was where he was spotted in France with Nigerians screaming "Ole, ole" at him. But not too long ago, he returned back immediately. He thinks Nigerians don't understand all of these things. He has returned back. He came back to the country and visited Sanwo-Olu, the governor of Lagos State. That's his godson. We know godfather and godson is still working. And came out to say, "I'm still here. I didn't go anywhere. I'm still the Jagaban of Lagos." When you were spotted in France, why didn't you speak immediately? It's only a couple of hours, guys. We know this thing very well. From Nigeria here to UK, how many hours? Even from here to France, how many hours? So we know, and these guys, they have access to private jets. They can zoom in, zoom out, zap in, zap out, all at the expense of Nigerians. Right now, he's screaming that Lekki Tollgate killings have complicated matters for him. He hasn't seen anything yet. His political career is gone. Gone. Dead and gone. Anyway, guys, we'll get more details. We'll find out what he's really lamenting and what he's screaming about. We'll bring you all of the details shortly. But before we do, guys, please, if you haven't given us a thumbs up yet, do go ahead and give us a thumbs up. Click on the like button. Don't forget to subscribe as well. Hit on the subscribe button. It really does mean a lot to us. And share our news, please. We want everyone to be informed about what's going on in the country. Thank you, my beautiful people. Yes, we'll go into the news now and grab all of the details. Lekki Tollgate killings have complicated matters for me, Tinubu. The national leader of the All Progressive Congress, Asewaju Bola Tinubu, has said the hashtag #EndSARS protests and its fallout, including the shooting of peaceful protesters at the Lekki Tollgate by soldiers, have complicated matters for him. Tinubu lamented that he was first accused of sponsoring the hashtag #EndSARS protest, then later accused of sending soldiers to shoot at the protesters at the Lekki Tollgate on Tuesday night to disperse them. He said his political enemies falsely claimed that he sent soldiers to the tollgate because he has financial interest in the tollgate and he was losing revenue due to the prolonged protest. He, however, described the claims as complete and terrible lie, saying they were being sponsored by his political enemies to pit him against the state and the federal government. In a statement on Sunday titled "The Hashtag #EndSARS Protest, A Fundamental Lesson in Democratic Governance," Tinubu stressed that he neither have investment in the Lekki Tollgate nor sent soldiers to disperse the protesters, but admitted that "I am indeed a promoter and financier investor in the Nation newspaper and TVC." He said he got prior information that facilities of both the Nation newspaper and TVC were going to be attacked by certain malevolent elements hiding under hashtag #EndSARS protest. Yet, he did not send soldiers or policemen there to prevent the attack because he didn't want anyone to die. "There is no rationale that can adequately explain why I would order soldiers to repel peaceful protesters from the tollgate where I have no financial interest, yet choose to do nothing to protect my investment in the Nation and TVC," Tinubu said. He said the attack on TVC and the Nation newspaper were carried out by the hirelings of his political enemies. Tinubu said, "The present situation clearly does nothing to profit me politically or otherwise. It has complicated matters for me because many people are wrongfully blaming me for a violent incident in which I played no part. Still, I stand strongly behind the people of Nigeria and affirm their right to protest peacefully. Along with all well-meaning patriotic Nigerians, I want to see an end to all forms of institutionalized brutality, and I shall do my utmost to see that the humane object is realized." So guys, Bola Tinubu, two things here is doing right now. He's lamenting that hashtag NSAS. We heard it now, but right now he's blaming his political enemies that they are the ones complicating matters for him. He still wants to rule this country, but he should know very well that no one is going to support him come 2023. It's bad governance we're protesting against now. If we vote for Tinubu again in 2023, then what was the point of coming out? What was the point? The people that the heroes that lost their lives on the Tuesday night, leading from the Tuesday night, then it would have been in vain. Anyway, guys, he's raising alarm that he has no hand, and he has been making a lot of deniers, said he doesn't have any connection with Lekki toll gate, of which we know that Tinubu is the one that controls Lekki toll gate, but he's claiming that he doesn't have any connection, that he only has connection with TVC and the Nation's newspaper, that they want to finish his political career, but he's strongly behind Nigerians. You can see that he's already campaigning for 2023, but it won't work. It will not work. Ah, it has passed. It won't work. Like I stated, if we open our eyes again to vote for Tinubu come 2023, that means lives were just lost in vain, and we wouldn't want that to happen. So, guys, I do want us to leave your take. Let's hear what you think. All Tinubu is trying to drive at right now, he's been stating that he's in support of the youth, support of Nigerians, is against brutality and all of that. This is someone who has pocketed millions of Lagosians, and nothing that goes through Lagos that is not Tinubu connected. His children are here, lodgers, they are this and that everywhere in Lagos State, of which we know very well, and is claiming he has so much interest for the people that he's doing his best. Guys, let's hear your take. Thank you once again. Please, if you haven't given us a thumbs up, do go ahead and give us a thumbs up. Click on the like button. Don't forget to subscribe as well. Hit on the subscribe button. It really does mean a lot to us. Till I come your way again, bye for now and God bless.